Arizona. The license plate game. I'm sure some of you are familiar with the license plate game. When you see a license plate that's from out of state, you call it out, and you get to smack somebody if you call it out first. I guess I'll call those out sporadically through the trip as I notice them. If you see one that I miss, call it out in the comments. I'll remember you. I'll give you shout-outs and stuff. It'll be cool. Yeah, let's make it official. Let's do the license plate game on this trip. Anytime I see an out-of-state plate, I will call it out and I'll smack myself because I'm not traveling with anyone else. New York. I'll have to do the actual smacking later on because I need both of my hands right now. Splitting is dangerous business. New York, there we go. Got my New York smack on. Arizona. So, every time I see a plate, I'll call it out, I'll smack myself. And if you spot one in my video that I don't spot and you call it out correctly in the comments, yeah, I will give you credit for that. And I'm planning to do some sort of giveaway in the future if I can manage it, if I can find an affordable way to do it. So everybody who gets a correct plate, out-of-state plate that I miss in one of my videos in this California Coast road trip series, I will give you a shout out and I will give you a treat if I do manage to pull off the treat production in an affordable manner. So keep an eye out for those out-of-state plates. And of course, out-of-country is worth it too, so keep that in mind. What's this one? I can't read it yet. One advantage I do have is I'm not competing with you guys for time, so I can wait until I get close enough. Minnesota. So I'm pretty sure we're in Malibu now. This is the city of Malibu. I may be wrong. I'm often wrong, which is okay. It's okay. It's okay to be wrong once in a while. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now we're in Malibu. I called it out about a half a mile too early. These things are so dumb. They're so inconsistent. Okay, so they have these speed things set up all over California. I don't know if you guys have these wherever you're from, but they set up these signals that will tell you how fast you're going. They put it under the speed limit, so you could say, okay, this is how fast you're going, this is how fast you're supposed to be going. And each one of them will tell you different speeds when you're traveling at the same speed. In other words, if I pass one of these signs doing 40 miles an hour, one of them will tell me I'm doing 43, one of them will tell me I'm doing 37. And if you pass the same sign multiple times on different days, sometimes it'll give you different speeds too. Like I go past, they have one of these set up a couple blocks away from my house where I live. And every day I pass it, I make sure I'm going the speed limit just to test the sign. So I'll go 40 miles an hour, which is the speed limit, past the sign every day. Some days it'll tell me I'm doing 38, some days it'll tell me I'm doing 46, some days it'll tell me I'm doing 40, some days it'll tell me I'm doing 37. It's just completely, like, I don't know how these things work, but whatever the mechanism is pretty unreliable. So I don't know why they even put them up. I guess it's just to grab your attention. It seems like if the thing tells me I'm doing 37 when I'm really doing 40, and I don't know that that thing is incorrect, I might feel like, oh, this is something that the government put up. It must be accurate. There's another 3 miles an hour faster I could go. So then I could go faster, and now I'm in, you know, I could get in trouble for speeding or something. So I think it's really stupid that they put those things up if they're not going to be accurate. If they were accurate, you know, that'd be another story, but they just, like, they don't make any effort to ensure that the technology is going to be reliable before they throw it out there. Now, I think people are getting a lot of misleading information out of them.